Welcome back. The Curious Joel case went all the way to the U.S. Supreme Court. And in part two of my interview with Louis Gourmet, the co-author of The Curious Case of Curious Joel, we discussed that and a lot more.
This was a bipartisan affair. You had Democratic governor, then Mario Cuomo, Republican, obviously, Assemblyman George Pataki. And it's so funny how this would intersect with son of Cuomo and Pataki would become governor, a democratically controlled assembly. But they all believed, didn't they, that, well, then the courts will stop it. If we don't stop it and it's not vetoed, then the courts will stop it.
Mel Miller said to me when I interviewed him for the book a number of years later, and he was on tape, he said, look, I finally gave in on this because of the politics, because, he said, the governor was going to veto it. We all knew that a great constitutional lawyer like Mario Cuomo would never sign this bill. And even if he didn't, somebody would come along and beat it in court. It was open, shut, unconstitutional. And he was right. That's what happened. But how I got involved is I was the executive director of the State School Boards Association. We represented all the school boards in New York. And for us, this was Armageddon. If any group could decide to opt out of a school district because they wanted to, Mid-Hudson has several communities of retirees. They live in wealthy school districts, many of them. Let's say they all got together since they had no kids and formed their own school district in order to not pay taxes.
Oh, it'd be madness. Yeah.
It was absolute madness, not to mention the fact that America was built on religious freedom. And to say that we can have every religion having their own little theocracy would be a blackboard jungle. It would be terrible. So I got involved because I was the executive director. And I went to Monroe Woodbury and I said, you know, guys, you ought to serve these kids better. I'll show you how to do it. I used to run that program. Nobody was interested. Everybody wanted to let these people go. But it never dawned on me that my mentor, Mario Cuomo, would support this. He was not publicly in support of this bill. It was quiet. So I go to see the governor several days after the bill passes, and I said to him, oh, great God, you probably don't know what happened the final night of the legislative session, but this bill went through both houses unanimously in one house, one vote against it, the local assembly person, by the way, in the other house, and you have to veto it. This is the most unconstitutional thing going. Now, let's remember, we're talking here in 1989.
Right.
And Cuomo looks at me and he says, Luigi, which is what he used to call me, Luigi, these people don't ask for much. And I suddenly realized, oh my God, it's his bill. And he said, there aren't that many kids, they need this service. And I said, Governor, I will get every one of those kids free public services, good ones, I promise. And he said, no, it's going to go forward, I'm going to sign the bill. And then he said, and who would sue? And I said, I would. And he said, why would you sue? And I said, well, Governor, when I worked for you, you used to tell me that the First Amendment is what separates civilized beings from everybody else. And I believe you. And so I sued. And 4 years later, we won in the Supreme Court of the United States, 6-3. And 4 days later, Mario Cuomo put another bill through the legislature, again, the last night of the legislative session. I love these bills that go to last night.
That.
I used to refer to them as vampire bills. They couldn't stand the light of day. And Cuomo puts a bill through, and it was terribly drafted. And I sued the next day, and we beat it unanimously in the Court of Appeals. The Supreme Court wouldn't even consider it this time. So then Mario Cuomo goes, and he runs for election. He goes to the village of Curious Joel, and he says to the people in the village, and if this bill, meaning the second one, which was live at that time, is declared unconstitutional, we will, Shelley and I, who, by the way, is speaker by this stage, we're talking 94.
Mm-hmm.
Shelley and I will put in another bill. And if that's declared unconstitutional, we will put in another bill. And so what had become a sort of intellectual battle suddenly became a blood battle. All of the media and the courts were on one side, and both parties were on the other side. You couldn't believe this wasn't the Deep South. This was New York State we were talking about. And it was an unbelievable situation, and it went on for 10 years. And we won. We kept winning every time. We were in court 11 times. We won 11 times, and including 3 Court of Appeals decisions and 1 Supreme Court decision. Finally, I leave because, you know, I go on to other things, and a fourth bill passes. And the fourth bill becomes so broad that it doesn't have any legal problems. It has much more serious problems. The first bill and the second bill and the third bill had problems of church-state.
Yep.
The fourth bill had a problem of retirees. It has a problem that any group of people who can meet the criteria in that bill. Now, the good news is we created such a stink that nobody has done it. But they could. It's sitting out there.
You know, whatever people feel about the idea of trying to create, in effect, theocracies, we are on the same page of that. This isn't America. But on the flip side, to do that and then to demand to be subsidized by taxpayers of all different faiths on your own terms, and consequently shortchanging everyone else in the community because you're siphoning off that tax base for a particular need in a particular group, there's a cause and effect to that, and it's just not fair on a more basic level.
Well, let me make a distinction between the Satmar and the Amish. The Amish say, leave us alone and don't give us any money. We don't want any part of you. The Hasids, as you point out, I'm talking particularly about the Satmar and Curious Joel, feel very strongly that they want the federal government and the state government to pay to build a wall around them, a ghetto wall around them. And I kept saying, guys, the same government that is allowed to build a ghetto wall because you want it are going to be allowed to build a ghetto wall because the people outside don't want you. See, my problem here is not with the Satmar. The Satmar have the right to ask for anything they want. That's freedom of speech, freedom of assembly, and freedom of religion. The state of New York has a constitutional obligation to say, not in the United States of America. And they failed utterly.
Again, the reason why, even if you're not as invested in this subject, if you don't live in Curious Joel or East Ramapo for that matter, or down in Brooklyn, this is America, and this is fascinating that this happens. Again, it's called The Curious Case of Curious Joel. Lou, I appreciate the time. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Well, that's going to do it for our program tonight. Thank you so much for joining us this evening. We'll see you back here tomorrow night, 6 p.m. as always. See you then.